إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. This is one of the greatest ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent among the believers, this messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, certainly did Allah confer great favor upon the believers when He sent among them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a messenger from themselves. They know him. They know his parents. They know his akhlaq. Alayhi salatu wassalam. Everything was clear. Reciting to them his verses and purifying them and teaching them the book, which means the Quran, and wisdom, although they had been before in manifest error. This is a great ni'mah, a great favor upon the believers when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take them out from the ظلمات, darknesses, to the nur, the light of Islam. And he told us subhanahu wa ta'ala to obey this messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. All you who have believed, don't put yourself before Allah and His Messenger. Your opinion should be behind the book of Allah, the Quran, and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On top of everything, the Quran and the Sunnah. Before yourself, before your Sheikh, before your desire, the Quran and the Sunnah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In many ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Why to obey him? He said, and obey Allah and the Messenger that you may obtain mercy. It is not a punishment. It is not to make your life difficult. Some people claim that when you follow the Sunnah, it will be difficult, complicated. You'll not enjoy your life. Subhanallah. Allah says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. الرَّحْمَةِ. The mercy where? In obeying Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالُ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَصْلِحُوا ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. This is a sign of your iman. This is condition of your iman, to obey Allah and His Messenger. He said at the beginning of Surah Al-Anfal,
وأطيعوا الله ورسوله إن كنتم مؤمنين. Obey Allah and His Messenger if you should be believers. سبحان الله. الرحمة والإيمان, the mercy, the faith, where? In obeying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should follow only the Quran. We obey Allah. It is not wajib to obey Rasulullah. Some people have this wrong concept. We have to follow only the Quran. The Sunnah, Sunnah. Mustahab, not wajib, wrong concept. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his book, the Quran, he said, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. And whatever the messenger has given you, take, which means you have to follow. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. You have to follow. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. And what he has forbidden you, refrain from. So this is in the Quran. This is in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a clear ayah. This is a clear ayah for those who claim what is wajib from the Quran, what is sunnah from hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is wrong. The wajib can be in the Quran or the sunnah. I mean the hadith. And what is mustahab can be in the Quran or from the sunnah. It depends on the rulings from the fuqaha, how they explain the Quran and the Sunnah. They join the proofs from the Quran and Sunnah, then they decide this is wajib or mustahab. But it can be from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some wajib compulsory rules. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to tell us the danger of deviating from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You should stick to the Sunnah to save yourself. فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, so let those beware who dissent from his order, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lest fitna strike them or a painful punishment. This is the sunnah, clear. Very clear, alhamdulillah, Islam is clear. The sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is clear. Follow the sunnah. Don't take any path here or there other than the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnah of Abu Hanifa, sunnah of Malik, sunnah of Shafi'i, sunnah of Ahmad ibn Hanbal. If it is not with the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't follow that. Don't follow that. A man asks Imam al-Shafi'i, al-Muttalibi, rahimahullah ta'ala, about an issue. He gave him the answer from the Quran and the Sunnah. Then he said, and what is your opinion? Now I know what is the ruling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is your saying? What is your opinion? Imam Shafi'i got angry. He said, "Atara alayya az-zinnar?" What do you see? Do you see the belt of the, which means the Christians? Har ra'aytani kharij min kanisa? Have you seen me getting out of a church? A'udhu billah. This is not Islam. What he means, this is not Islam. I'm telling you the Quran and the Sunnah, then you ask me about my opinion. This is not Islam. Clear the ayah, the hadith, fatwa from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then you like to know what is the opinion of the Imam Ibn Baz or Al-Albani or Al-Shafi'i or Ibn Taymiyyah. We respect our scholars. But if there is a saying from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nothing after that. Abdullah ibn Umar narrated a hadith saying, لا تمنعوا, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تمنعوا إماءكم المساجد. لا تمنعوا إماءكم المساجد. Don't stop your women, which means your daughter, your sister, your wife, if you are the guardian. Don't stop them from going to the masjid. She likes to pray Taraweeh. You give her the permission, which means that she has to take the permission from the husband, the father, before going to the masjid. One of his children, one of his sons, Abdullah ibn Umar, one of the sons of Abdullah ibn Umar, said, وَاللَّهِ لَنَمْنَعَهُنْ إِذَنْ يَتَّخِذْنَهُ دَغَلًا. By Allah, I will stop them. I will not give them the permission to pray in the masjid. يَتَّخِذْنَهُ دَغَلًا. They will take this as an excuse to go here or there, or to chat with the friends, something like that. Abdullah ibn Umar got very angry. He said, I am telling you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, don't stop them. And you are opposing that by saying, I will stop them. He started to insult his son, and he did not speak to his son. His son, he loves him, but he loves the sunnah more than his son. This is the practice of Islam. This is the way to practice Islam properly. The priority for the sunnah, not for my desire. قُلْ أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in many ayat. I mentioned more than one ayah to emphasize this concept. Say, obey Allah and obey the messenger. Wajib to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if you like to save yourself from the hellfire. وَقُلْ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وحده وأصلي وأسلم على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. ونع عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه was doing the tawaf and the sunnah in the tawaf. You go to the الحجر الأسود, the black stone, to kiss the الحجر الأسود if you can, if it is possible. He said رضي الله تعالى عنه والله إني لأعلم أنك حجر لا تضر ولا تنفع ولولا أني رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقبلك ما قبلتك. By Allah, I know that you are a stone, can neither benefit or harm or nor harm. Had I not seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kissing you, I would never have touched or kissed you. He knows, he believes this stone cannot help. Hajar al-Aswad cannot help you. But what he said? Because I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kissing you. So that's why I'm kissing Hajar al-Aswad. This is the understanding of Umar al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. I don't understand why, but I am sure it is not beneficial for me. I mean, he means radiyallahu ta'ala anhu cannot benefit us, al-Hajar al-Aswad, cannot give us the rain, the rizq, the cure. But because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did that, I'm doing that. Do you have this concept? You follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, trusting everything in the sunnah for us, to benefit us. Don't think the best thing is the sunnah in Ramadan. Many people ask, it's better I give zakat al-fitr as money. What is the sunnah? The sunnah to give food. But Imam Abu Hanifa said it is allowed. Subhanallah. And where is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We respect Imam Abu Hanifa. We respect the scholar who said it is allowed. There is an opinion that it is allowed to give us money. But why you ignore the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it is very easy for you to do? You give 2 or 3 kilos of food, dates, rice. Easy. No, it's better for the poor and the needy to get money. Subhanallah. You know what is better for them? than the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is one of the biggest problems of the Muslim ummah. We mentioned the ayah, لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. Don't put your opinion before the opinion, the saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Follow the sunnah. Ask, what is the sunnah? The sunnah to give food or money? Food. You give food. This is a sign that you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala an said, فَمَا لَنَا وَلِلْرَّمَلْ إِنَّمَا كُنَّا رأينا به المشركين وقد أهلكهم الله. ثم قال شيء صنعه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا نحب أن نتركه. After that عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه said there is no reason for us to do رمل. رمل which means the first three rounds around the Kaaba, you walk fast, little bit fast, رمل. Why we are doing Ramal? We did that when we entered Mecca in the seventh year to show off the mushrikeen that we are strong. But now Mecca is a Muslim country. So what is the point that we do Ramal now? It is a place of Islam. Country of Islam, all of them Muslims. He said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, but we don't like to leave anything that the Prophet ﷺ was doing. So we don't like to leave that. Which means to follow the sunnah. وَإِن تُطِيعُهُ تَهْتَدُوا. When you obey him, you will be guided. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم احفظ إخوانا المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم نجهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم نجي إخوانا المسلمين المستضعفين في غزة وفي السودان وفي مشارق الأرض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجمع المسلمين على التوحيد والسنة يا رب العالمين. من أرادنا والمسلمين بسوء فرد كيده في نحره وأشغله في نفسه يا رب العالمين. احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات يا رب العالمين ومعاكسات من وسائل التواصل التي دمرت الشباب والبنات يا رب العالمين. اللهم انزل علينا مطرا مباركا ينبت الزرع ويسمن الرعي يا رب العالمين. اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم بلغنا رمضان ويسر لنا الصلاة والصيام والقيام فيه يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.